Hello everyone, and welcome to the first video of a Let's Play series that I have been very much looking forward to. You could say it's almost 15 years in the making. We're getting there. We're almost getting 15 years from when this game came out. But this is going to be the first episode and hopefully a very long series about Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 is one of my favorite games of all time. It is part of the legendary AKI-developed wrestling games that were published by THQ, and it was a Japanese-only release. So not many people have heard of it or have gotten a chance to play it. Obviously, today is one of the best ways to play it is via a ROM and an emulator, but I am actually recording this off of the cartridge of Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Now, a few things about this video. This is going to be an introduction video. I'll have some gameplay at the end, but since Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 might not be something that many people are familiar with, if you've been familiar with like No Mercy and WrestleMania 2000 or WCW NW Revenge, you still might not have known about this game because it was a Japanese-only release. And if you maybe weren't, you know, super hardcore into import games during the year of 2000, which was no easy task. It's a lot easier now to import games for the systems, but or if you weren't hardcore into Japanese wrestling, it's very likely you didn't hear about this game. Fortunately for me and for you guys, I was into those things. This was actually, no, I don't think it was the first game I imported, but it was definitely the game that actually helped expand my interest in Japanese wrestling. And that was, you know, if you were watching the intro looks very familiar, right? It looks like the WrestleMania 2000 intro because, well, that game and all the other games have a lot in common. I mean, and this has a lot in common with WrestleMania 2000, but what you're about to see is that this game was a lot of the inspiration for what they would do for WWF No Mercy. So, real quick, Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, its subtitle is Odo Kisho. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Excuse my Japanese. basically, it translates to Royal Road Succession. So this game was released January 28th of 2000. And WrestleMania 2000, to put that in perspective, was released October 99. And No Mercy was released in November of 2000. So this was right in between. So you gotta believe they were developing this right alongside WrestleMania 2000. And this was not the first Japanese wrestling game that AKI developed. There was actually Virtual Pro Wrestling 64. And that came out a month after WCW versus NWO World Tour. Way back in 97, Virtual Pro Wrestling 64 came out in December of 97, and WCW versus NWO World Tour came out of November 97. So that was technically the first wrestling game that AKI had developed for the N64, and then they simultaneously released Virtual Pro Wrestling 64. But it wasn't until, you know, 2000 that we finally get a sequel to Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Meanwhile, we had, after World Tour, we had Revenge, and we had WrestleMania 2000. They changed licenses from WCW to WWF. So here we are, flash forward several years later, or about 3 years later, I should say, we get Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Why is this game my favorite game? Well, as much as I love No Mercy, and as much as I have like a very nostalgic part in my heart for WrestleMania 2000, I feel like this game is a perfect blend of all the other games, all the games that came before it, and even what would come after it, No Mercy, because there was a lot of stuff that I felt should have been included in No Mercy, but for whatever reason, wasn't. No Mercy did add a few things graphically. It does look a little bit better. You know, this, you know, as you saw in that intro, it looks exactly like WrestleMania 2000 because it was being developed right alongside it, so that makes sense. And they added a few more gimmick matches. You know, you had the ladder match, you had a steel cage match, which was not in this game. You had the Iron Man match, you had the referee mode. So there was a few things in No Mercy that wasn't in this game that they added, but I still think there was some features in this game that I'm going to dive into for this video that I really feel helped put it over the top. And there's just something about the roster. The roster is so timeless, considering what would happen a few months after this game's release in the world of Japanese wrestling. There's just something historic about this roster. And, you know, I'll talk about it when I get to the roster, but just the flexibility they had with who they could put in this game, for me, really helped put it over the top. If you're like a wrestling fan, like of, you know, of just pure wrestling, there's no reason why you wouldn't like this game. It has not only a lot of great Japanese wrestlers that were popular at the time, but it actually has a lot of classic Japanese wrestlers, a lot of famous legends, and also a lot of famous American legends who spent a lot of time in Japan traveling, you know, during the time of like the NWA era and all that stuff. I'll get into that. I'll get into all of that. If you don't know me by now, it's probably because I haven't introduced myself. I am Be Better Gamer. This is the first episode of my Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 series. Please watch my WWF No Mercy series, where I do the light heavyweight run and the European run. I've also have some WCW NWO Revenge videos that I put up. They're just playthroughs. I will be getting to do Let's Plays of those soon, where I'll add commentary. But this video is all about Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. So let's get started. Let's talk about it. So where do I begin? Oh man, there's so much stuff to talk about. This is probably going to be a long video. I'm basically going to run through all the menus. So here we are. This is the homepage. This is the first screen you get to. The music might sound familiar. Again, they use a lot of the assets from WrestleMania 2000. But basically, here we go. From top left down, the first column we have, that's exhibition. That's where you're going to go do your single matches, your tag matches, whatever. This is league mode. Now, if you're familiar with Japanese wrestling, then you'll know that they do a lot of round robin tournaments. Both a lot of the top promotions have these like festivals that last several days where they do a tournament but in a round robin style. If you're not familiar with a round robin style, you know, it's you'll have a bracket and everyone will have to face each other at least once, right? So if you have 12 guys, instead of like a single elimination tournament, you know, let's say the Rock will face Austin, you know, first night, and then later on that night, The Rock will face Jericho, and then The Rock will face Mick Foley, and then The Rock will face Brock Lesnar, and he'll go through everyone throughout the course of the tournament. And you get points if you win, and sometimes you get points if you lose, sometimes you don't, depends on the league, whoever's doing it. In this game, it's like you get 2 points if you win, one if you lose, or is it 3 points if you win? I think it's 3 points if you win. Whatever. You get points if you win. No, that's not how it is. You get 2 points if you win, one if you tie, zero if you lose. That's how it works. Oh my god, I'm forgetting everything already. I was going over my notes before this video, so I made sure I remember everything about this game, and I'm already forgetting it. So that's the league mode, and then at the end, whoever has the most points either wins the whole shebang, or if there's a tie, then you have a tiebreaker match. Very cool that that's in this game. Remember that, because we'll get back to it later. The next mode is Rally, and Rally mode is basically the pay-per-view option that they had in WrestleMania 2000, which they took out in No Mercy. In No Mercy, you couldn't create custom pay-per-views, which I thought was nice if you wanted to simulate some stuff. When I was a kid, I used to get bored. Not bored, but, you know, I had a lot of time on my hands with these games. So I used to recreate pay-per-views for fun, you know? I used to, like, recreate, you know, WrestleMania and, like, do all the matches as they were and then play them all out and play them, like, the way I wanted to play them, you know? That's cool. And they have that in this game. It's really fun to create your own cards. And here you can do a lot of fantasy matchups. You can do a lot of fantasy cards, you know, have, you know, Keiji Muto take on Terry Funk or something like that. You know what I mean? Anyway, this is edit mode. Edit mode is edit mode. We all know edit mode from WrestleMania 2000s when it was introduced, and WWF No Mercy's extensive edit mode. I'll get to that in a second. Up right, we have Royal Road Secession. Royal Road Secession is basically Road to WrestleMania. Now, the interesting thing about Royal Road Secession is that it follows like kind of like how the Japanese tours work for the different promotions. It's not like how it is over here in America where WWE is like just 24/7 nonstop, like all year round. Every Monday there's going to be a Monday Night Raw. Every month there's going to be a pay-per-view. In Japan, it's a little different. The organizations have tours, and those tours stretch from certain months. Recently, you know, there was a lot of buzz about Wrestle Kingdom, Wrestle Kingdom 9, and that's New Japan's Tokyo Dome show. It's basically their WrestleMania. And after that ends, then, you know, they take a little break, and then they start up again around this time, actually. I think they just started up again, and they do a new tour stretching out for the year. So you hear a lot of wrestlers talk about back in the day, they used to love going to Japan because there was more flexibility with the dates and the tours and a lot less stressful. So the Royal Road Secession tries to emulate that, and you go through different tours. The interesting thing about Royal Road Secession, I'm going to hop in it real quick. See, I got a tour going real quick. If you look on the upper left, there's a 5. And that's the month. So that's the month we're in, right? That's May? Or is that the match? That might be the match. Huh. I always get them confused. I know either the upper left is the... Well, let me just start a new one. So I'm going to start a new one. So this is basically like, you know, Road to WrestleMania. You pick your character. So I'm going to pick Kobashi. And then I'm going to pick Jun Akiyama. And then I'm going to start. And then it's just going to hop right into... So, you know, it's playing the music, and it's telling you. So, I think, yeah, it shows you the month you start out in, right? It's all in Japanese, so I don't read all of it. So, yeah, so this is month, I'm in the month of May. So, this tour is starting in May. And I think it's right at the end of the May. On the bottom right, you see in the upper top heading, you have Kobashi, AKI. That's where I'm fighting. I'm fighting the AKI Hall. And then it has a list of matches, and you fight the matches. Looks familiar, right? So, then... You know, let me exit out of that. I've memorized these menus, by the way, because even 15 years later, I still remember them. And it basically breaks down. At first, it might look a little weird, right? Because you just see all the Japanese symbols, and you're like, what the hell is this? And you see all these zeros and whatever. But if you're very familiar with Road to WrestleMania, you'll be able to see, okay, that's probably the win, loss, and ties. And that's probably... You know, what belts were won, and on the bottom, like the special tournaments. And yeah, you'd be correct in thinking that. Now, Royal Road Secession follows kind of the All Japan pro wrestling tour, because this game, if you know from the intro, it was, if you noticed, if you're familiar with you know Japanese wrestling but never played this game, or even if you're not familiar with Japanese wrestling, basically the license for this game revolved around the All Japan Pro Wrestling organization. So all the All Japan Wrestling wrestlers, you can see their symbol kind of in the background from All Japan Pro Wrestling. That's the license. So think like WCW and WWF or WWE. All Japan Pro Wrestling was the license. And that's very important. I'll get to that when I get to edit mode, but I want to keep going right here. This is tournament that I'm highlighted on. That's your standard, you know, regular tournament. You go in, you choose your setting. Do you want to put a belt? And you can do up to 16, you know, standard, like the kind of the King of the Ring modes in the other games. So this is ranking. So this is a very interesting mode. Ranking, I gotta hop into it to say. So right here, I already set this up a while back. Basically, you choose profiles instead of the wrestlers, right? So I put profile 1, 2, 3, as you can see. And it starts off with the tournament. And I'm assuming this mode was meant to be played with other people. I guess people could, when you invite people over, you can hop back in and out, and you can fight for your rankings, you know, once you've done the tournament to establish who's on top. So number 2 profile, he won the tournament, you know, imagine, and now he's on top, and number 1 is ranked 1, and number 3 is ranked 2. So when you go ahead and you go into the ranking after you've done the tournament, you get to choose who fights who to move up in the ranking or to challenge maybe the champion. It's definitely a multiplayer, sort of like a local multiplayer aspect of it. It's really neat. I never really used it back in the day. You can do up to 16 profiles. See right here, these are all the profiles. And the reason why it's profiles instead of tournament, like, you know, instead of just doing a regular tournament or league, I'm guessing the reason why they did this is because, okay, well, maybe you wanted to do something and keep rank between your friends. So you all enter your friend's name. And then, you know, if two of your friends come over, you guys can fight for rankings against each other, you know, and do stuff like that and trade off. So it attaches it to the profile. That's kind of cool. A feature I never really used as a kid because, honestly, I played this game with, like, one, maybe two other people the most. Because, you know, a lot of my friends, they were more into the WWF and WCW. They didn't really know a lot about Japanese wrestling. And this was, like, pre-YouTube era. So I'm talking about, you know, the only way to really learn about Japanese wrestling or follow it was, like, through tape trading and things like that. Now it's a lot easier. You can just go on YouTube and find everything and anything. So anyone can become a fan of this stuff. But back then, it wasn't as easy to get into. So, you know, when my friends would come over, they would want to play No Mercy or WrestleMania 2000 or even Revenge. Very few people wanted to play Virtual Wrestling 2 because they weren't familiar with the wrestlers. So it was like me and, like, you know, my best friend at the time. We were the only ones who ever played it. So we never did ranking. But that's a pretty cool feature. This menu right here is options. Just to let you know, I'm playing on very hard like I always do. One of the cool things here, you can choose your referees. So these are the referees you can choose, and they all have different properties. There's actually a hidden referee that you can unlock, and he's like an older referee, and he counts slow. They're all based off of real referees. I don't remember their names right now, but that's pretty cool. There's also a option. Let me look it up real quick, because I wrote it down. So you choose your referee, and then what's that? That's referee. I think this is like, what is that, sound? I think that's sound. And then, no, that's sound. That's sound. You can kind of, that's controller input. Okay, this is really cool. This is what I like. So this is an area. Let me see if I can find it. Here we go. Where you can look at the records of everyone in the game. So as you can sort them by matches won. You know, Dragon Kid has the most matches. One, you can sort it by, like, win percentage. You can sort it by losses. That's pretty neat. I always like that. And then you can look at the last matches you did. See, I had a Jushin Thunder Liger match against Koji Kanemoto, and then a Liger match against Ataka Michinoku, Yuji Nagata against Mordecai Mossman. Like, look at all these matches. Like, it'll show you your most recent matches. That's pretty neat. And these top two options, this one's for the created wrestler, this one's for the created belt. You can transfer them between the memory packs. So I thought that was pretty cool in this game. Again, a feature not in any of the other games, but I think it would really be cool. I'm really all about stats in video games. Like, I love looking at, like, my Wii U stats for, like, how long I've played a game, or how many times I played it, or how many hours I spent in a game. Or I love reading when, like, people post articles of, like, you know, there's been this many matches, you know, in Halo matchmaking or whatever. I'm all about the stats, and I love that they put this kind of feature in the game, because you can scroll through everyone, you can see who you play as a lot, who you don't play as a lot. Now, I should say something about this cartridge. The stats are pretty, you know, sparse, right? So it's like Dragon Kid, 15 matches. But didn't he say he played this game when he was a kid? This is not the actual cartridge I had as a kid. I did get this game right when it came out. I followed it online, and, you know, as best as I could. You know, it was all message boards and stuff like that. Basically finding news about this game. And I went to Chinatown. I used to live in New York. I'm in Buffalo right now, but I used to live in Brooklyn. And I went to Chinatown, and I asked the guys at my Chinatown game store about it, and because they knew all about the import games. And they were aware of it, and they're like, yeah, we're getting the game in, you know, about a few weeks after it gets released. I was like, oh, really? Yeah? And I had to buy an adapter to plug into my N64 so that I could plug the Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 on top of it so that it could be read from the N64, because the cartridges on the Japanese cartridges are, you can't just insert them directly in an American system. So obviously I didn't know back then that all you had to do was just change the faceplate on the back and then you could put it in no problem. But you know, again, you didn't really know about these things back then. You just kind of figured it out. And I had it when it first came out. I put thousands of hours into that cartridge, man, into that game. I had the full box and everything. Since it was an import, I paid like $100 for the game alone. Okay, this was year 2000. I'm in early high school. I don't have a job. I saved up my money. You know, can't really buy many games throughout the year, but this was a game that I felt like I needed to have. Because I was such a huge fan of WrestleMania 2000, huge fan of Revenge, put in thousands of hours into those games. And that game stayed with me for a very long time. It was a dark period of my life where I had to sell a lot of my video games and collections of video games. And unfortunately, I had to part ways with my original cartridge of Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Things are a lot better now, obviously. And, I've been slowly trying to recollect all of those things that I've lost, which is where I wanted to be. You know, down the line, I wanted to regain these things. And last summer, I actually found a copy of Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 on eBay. So this is that copy. So this is not my original copy of Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, but this is a newer one. As you can see, I did edit already all the names. When I got the game, I was so excited to get the names. All the names and the promotions are edited. And I even began unlocking some characters. Mil Máscaras and Abdullah the Butcher I've unlocked. Ultimo Dragon and the Great Muda have been unlocked. But there's a lot more wrestlers I have to unlock. And there's a lot more things to unlock in this game. You can unlock costumes and outfits. You can unlock belts. You can unlock different modes. Just now when I started up this game, I unlocked all the moves from Revenge. So what they do in this game is you already have moves in the game that you can create wrestlers with, but they excluded all the like the WCW moves or the WWF moves that, you know, belong to, like, you know, the American wrestlers. So, like, you know, Hulk Hogan's taunts, or, you know, Goldberg's jackhammer, or The Rock's rock bottom. Like, all that stuff was hidden. And the way you get that in these games is basically you turn on your system a bunch of times. If you turn on the game 20 times, you unlocked all the Revenge moves. And then when you turn on your game 20 times, you unlock the No Mercy stuff. I mean, WrestleMania 2000 stuff. It's like little things like that, like the unlocks that really, for me, like, really put this game over the top. Little, like, intricacies into making a wrestling game have all this replay value, but reward you for putting in all that time and effort, because now you can, you know, access a whole bunch of more content. Nowadays, it would have just been DLC. You know, honestly, they would have done like a WCW pack or a WWF moves pack. I mean, I believe they do that now. I think WWE 2K15 just came out with like an expanded moves pack. And I think it's, you know, they took a lot of like indie moves and added it to the game. You know, now you gotta pay for it. But anyway, all right, so let's talk about this roster, right? Shall we? Because again, if you've probably never heard of this game, or you haven't followed Japanese wrestling, you don't know, like, who the hell is this old man just stretching his abs? This is Giant Baba, aka Shohei Baba, and he was the founder of All Japan Pro Wrestling. So he's like a Japanese legend. Yes, he really does look like that in real life. He's this tall, you know, old looking guy, especially around this time. He passed around the time this game launched. I forgot exactly when he passed. I forgot to look that up. But basically, it split up into different promotions. So this is the largest roster of all the other AKI developed games. This roster has, I wrote the number down. Let me look at it. Hold on. This roster has 96 wrestlers. There's 96 wrestlers in the game, 23 of which are hidden. And then, of course, you have your, you know, 16 slots where you can make new wrestlers. So you can have a potential of 114 wrestlers maxed out in this game alone. And that's not counting all the wrestlers you add on to your expansion pack. So even if you have one memory card, then that's another 16 wrestlers you can swap in and out at any moment. To put that in perspective, so you have 96 wrestlers, WWF No Mercy has 64 characters in it, and Revenge has 50 WCW wrestlers and 12 fake, quote unquote, fake wrestlers. Now, those wrestlers were actually, or those characters, I should say, were actually based off the Japanese wrestlers, whom they've already used, for Virtual Pro Wrestling 64. They kept some of them, but now here they are, they have a game of their own. And like I mentioned earlier, this has the All Japan license. So the roster starts out with All Japan. So the first column, you have your heavy hitters of All Japan. You have Mitsuhiro Masawa, Yoshinara Ogawa, Masahiro Kakihara, Kenta Kobashi, Jun Akiyama, Kentaro Shiga, Morikawa Mossman, aka Tao Kia, Jun Izumo. You get the picture. It has all the top guys. Now, the game doesn't come translated like this. I have all their names. The way I do it, everyone has a different system, but the way I did it, Vader's in this game, Big Van Vader, for all you WCW fans, and even WWF fans, he's in WWF, Stan Hansen's in it. So this game does have a lot of American wrestlers because, again, they toured a lot over there in Japan. And a lot of these guys, Johnny Ace, who you might know now as John Laurinaitis, he had a big career in Japan. Mike Barton, who people might know as Bart Gunn, Gary Albright, Johnny Smith, Giant Kamala. Yes, the Giant Kamala. He had a pretty big career in Japan as well. They put all the American wrestlers, if you notice, in this section, and all the Japanese All Japan mainstays are in the first two sections. They call American wrestlers gaijins in Japan, and usually, they're heels, they're bad guys. So Vader was a heel, Hansen was a heel. They're still beloved over there in Japan. People love them and they still respect them, but when it comes turn to the ring, the American wrestlers usually work heel and the Japanese wrestlers usually work babyface. But sometimes it switches. Sometimes they'll cheer for some of the faces, but that's how it was for a long time. So it wasn't translated. So let's take Vader for example. So you can go in and you can edit their name. See? Just like in when you're creating your own wrestler, but here you can actually edit the wrestlers. You can also do that in, WWF No Mercy and WrestleMania 2000. You can edit the wrestlers and their names. Same thing here. So, which is great because if you want to translate it, you can kind of translate it. You can choose the voices that they make, the sounds that they make, what they're going to say when they enter. Or how they're introduced, their music. This is what they say when they enter, which I'll show later on. They can actually say something when they enter. This is where it is. This is it. So if you hold down the up C, I think this was the what the ring announcer says. So when they come in, the ring announcer says their name. But this is what they, if you hold down like the up C or the down C button or the left C or the right C, when you're entering the ring, they'll say something. So that's really neat. So yeah, basically, you have their appearance you can edit. So you can go in, change, how they look or whatever, their faces, their outfits. And see it says Vader time. Again, they had the All Japan license. So Vader was already pre-made. This is where they keep the moves. So same setup, you're going in, looking at the moves. You can't edit the moves, unfortunately. This is their parameters, which we'll get into a little bit, because this is where you can choose when you're creating a wrestler to make a wrestler, a martial artist, or a mixed martial artist. That's right, MMA style wrestler. So we'll talk about that in a bit. And this is their logic, something that wasn't in the other games, where you can basically kind of dictate how the computer will behave if they're fighting in a match. So this is how you clone a wrestler, right? So then, all right, so this is default. Okay, so I'm doing this so you can see, because I'm gonna start talking about all the other guys for a second. And it's important to know, since this is an import game, from Japan, based off of real wrestling, so they had the All Japan license. So see, look, Vader, this is how Vader was. That's Vader's default, and then that's his regular outfit, right? So now, since I've already edited, now we're at New Japan. So this is New Japan Pro Wrestling. But now, so you're like thinking, okay, well, this is all Japan. So let's see, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14, 21. So only 21 wrestlers that they have the license for, okay? There's 96 wrestlers in the game. So that's, what is that, 75? That's 75 wrestlers that are in the game that they didn't have the license for. Here's Yuji Nagata. Looks like Yuji Nagata, right? There he is, Yuji Nagata. Hey, this is his second AKI developed wrestler, or third actually if you count virtual wrestling. But you might remember him from WCW, NW, or Revenge. So let's go to Yuji Nagata. So yeah, what I did is I went in there, I changed his name to Y Nagata, you know, Yuji Nagata. But I had to actually edit his appearance. This is how Yuji Nagata originally looked. On the left side, that's how he was when you first started up the game. But that's not Yuji Nagata, right? But it has his moves, you know, as you can see, like when he does his taunt. You know, go ahead, taunt Yuji Nagata, taunt. There you go. Yeah, that's Yuji Nagata, that's right. He does that in Revenge also. If you go to his moves and you go to his grapples, you look at his special, it's like, okay, he's gonna drop you down. His special, he's gonna go for a leg submission. What else does he do? Oh, he does the Northern Lights. Yeah, this is totally Yuji Nagata, right? His back special, what does he do? Oh yeah, the back neck drop. Yeah, this looks like Yuji Nagata. So you kind of just had to know. There was translation guides back in the den. That's how you knew which wrestlers were what, because you just kind of had to figure out. They would have these fake names. I don't remember what Yuji Nagata's fake name was in this game, you know, but it was probably something that gave the hint that it might be Yuji Nagata. This is how the Japanese wrestling games got around the licensing issues. So they couldn't put all these New Japan people in it. They couldn't put Scott Norton in the game and make him look like Scott Norton. They had to, you know, call him something else and, you know, make him look like this. That's not Scott Norton, right? But on the right side, that's Scott Norton. And if you go to his moves and you check out his moves, it's like, oh yeah, that's totally Scott Norton. So that's what the beauty of this game. It takes a little bit of time, but basically you go in and you edit all the wrestlers' appearances. And, you know, you create their alternate outfits, and then boom, you got Scott Norton in the game. So that's what I had to do. I had to go in, change everyone's name. There's Kojima, there's Tenzan, there's Keiji Muto, there's Masachono. You know, my favorite, this is probably my favorite bracket, Jushin Thunder Liger. These are all the junior heavyweights for New Japan. And this is what I had to do. I went in and I edited everyone's names and I edited their outfits so they can be basically who they're meant to be. There's another great Japanese wrestling series called Fire Pro Wrestling, where it's basically the same thing, and they have a lot more wrestlers too than these games did. But you have to edit the characters' appearance and their names, but it's basically the same person. And they have a lot of like more American guys. Like they have a lot more WWF and WCW guys. I don't think you could do that over here in these games. Like if that's why in Revenge you had the Executioner or those fake characters, but they had the actual Japanese movesets. But you couldn't edit them. You couldn't edit them, and I think there was probably a big legal gray area if they were to try to do that in WrestleMania 2000 and in No Mercy. I also think they probably didn't do that in those games because there was no real need to. I mean, you know, by that, you know, if you're selling a WWF game, chances are you can save space by, you know, taking out a bunch of Japanese wrestlers because maybe the audience might not be aware of it, or they might look at those fake wrestlers like you had in Revenge and not think to, oh, maybe this is really supposed to be Kenta Kobashi. He just looks like a ninja or something like that. So, but you could do that in this game. So all the wrestlers, all the different promotions, here's FMW, which was like the ECW, got Hayabusa was in it, Masada Tanaka, you know, Fuyuki, Mr. Ganosuke, Jado, Gato, Mike Awesome, Genichiro Tenryu. And it's actually really funny. So you have to be kind of creative when you're editing the names. At least I was. And again, everyone's got their own system, but you can't really fit Mr. Ganosuke fully. So if you see, I don't have a period after his R, and his short name is Suke. Because you can't really fit it. You know, it's maxed out. That's the unfortunate thing about this game. You know, Suke, you only have so many spaces. Fortunately enough, everyone's name pretty much fits, so you can get it. But you'll see some of that. You know, Jinsei Shinzaki's in here. Grace Suzuki's in here. Taka Michinoku's in here. Everyone knows Taka if you've played WWF games or if you watched it. Gran Naniwa, Super Delphin, Magnum Tokyo. You might remember him briefly being in WCW with the Dancing Fools. Sima, Dragon Kid, the prodigy to the, I mean, the protege to Ultimate Dragon. Junks, Perfects. This is supposed to be like Pancrase. I didn't edit these names actually, but this is supposed to be like Pancrase and you know, a lot of other MMA promotions. I wasn't a big MMA fan back in the day. I'm still not a huge MMA fan. I don't know a lot. I know that's supposed to be Masahiko Funaki or whatever his name is, Minoru Suzuki. I did edit these guys. There's a edit guide on Game Facts that someone recovered, because back in the day you had to find these Nobuhiko Takadas in this game. You had to find these edit guys kind of scattered all over the place. I believe there was like one website like run by Ice Master or whatever. He had all the edits in one place. You know, again, some of these guys are shooters, or like, you know, Minoru Tanaka's in this game before he went to New Japan. So some of these characters, you know, I don't know these wrestlers, especially the MMA guys. I didn't know who they were, so I just relied on the edit guide. But if you notice, so like, let's use Jinsei Shinzaki. If you go into the edit, so his face is 46, right? Jinsei is 46, okay? So that's his real face. So then Taka, okay, that looks like Taka. Well, what number his face? His face is 47, okay? And then when you go to edit Gran Aniwa, Delphin, Magnum Tokyo, his face is gonna be 48. So if you notice, the faces go in order to the, if you count up to 40 something, if you count up to 48, you'll get to Magnum Tokyo, excluding all the characters with mask. So they make it really easy in this game too to kind of figure out if you're going through the faces. Well, they're just basically going to be in order of the wrestlers, starting with Shohei Baba. If you go to his face, he's face number one. You know, face number two is gonna be, you know, Mitsuhiro Misawa. So it did make it easy for you to try to figure out how to exactly make sure who was who, because the faces all had them in order. And you know, they did take the real faces. Like, you can obviously see a lot of these, like, that's totally, you know, Chono. Like, look at Chono, that's Chono. If you've seen Chono, even WCW, if you saw him on Nitro fighting against Jericho or whatever, that's obviously Chono. So now, yeah, let's talk about my favorite feature of this game, the mask. Now, this was, you know, mind-blowing back in the day. Now, nowadays, in the more current video games, and a lot of other video games, they have the creative mask feature. But for, this time, it was a big deal. And obviously, in No Mercy, there's no creative mask feature. And it sucks, because, like, you can't create, like, let's say, Rey Mysterio Jr., who you could totally create in this game because you have the mask. You couldn't create Ultimate Dragon. You couldn't create guys who you might have wanted to create that wrestled in WCW and WWF and had the masks, because they didn't have this awesome create a mask feature. And basically, you know, what you did is you chose if they wore a mask or not. So if you press left or right, right here in the edit mode, see, you can change to do the mask. So when you go to the mask, it brings up a whole nother set of options, and you can change the different mask. They all have different colors. You can edit the colors. You can change it to see if it's like a mask where they have short hair, long hair coming out, or if the hair goes over. You can change the if they got a ponytail, if they got the tiger mask ears, if they got the horns, if they got the tiger mask other ears. And then like different extensions on the mask, so you could change like the different things. So cool. They basically have masks for all the mask wrestlers in the game. Obviously, look, this is, you know, you can see Jushin Thunder Liger. And the reason why it's yellow, you might be looking like, oh, why is that yellow and all those are white? Because you actually have to unlock some of these masks. So you actually have to unlock Liger's mask, which is kind of funny. They make you play as Liger like 10 times, and then when you play as Liger 10 times, you unlock his outfit. I believe you have to unlock, oh no, his stuff is already in the game. But yeah, that's like a different variation. That's Liger's like heavyweight pants and stuff like that. And that's just Liger's regular shirt. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I love that feature. You know, I was disappointed that that feature wasn't in, yeah, that's heavyweight Liger. That wasn't in No Mercy, because I would have loved to make like a Rey Mysterio or something like that, or even Ultimo Dragon. Luckily, Ultimo Dragon is a hidden character. My favorite wrestler, one of my favorite wrestlers, I should say, but probably my favorite wrestler to play as in WCW NWO Revenge. I'm glad he's in this game. And you have to unlock his outfits as well as unlock him. Great Muda, even though it's really cool that they got Great Muda in here, because even though they have Keiji Muto, you still, you know, they have his alternate personality, Great Muda, as an unlockable, which is really cool. And he's got like a completely different move set. You know, he's got a different finisher. He does like the miss and everything like that. You have to unlock his like face paint too and everything like that. And there's a few more hidden characters I have to unlock. Like I said, there's 23 hidden characters. So basically two rows of hidden characters. As you can see, I've only got four of them. A lot of my future Let's Play videos, I'm gonna, you know, walk through how to unlock the characters. Some of them are simple, like, you know, Abdullah the Butcher was easy, because you basically, like, you do a match and you put, you know, blood on. And then once you finish the match, he gets unlocked. Ultimo Dragon, I think you have to wrestle as like as cruiserweights for a little bit, and then you get Ultimo Dragon. Great Muda, you wrestle as like Keiji Muto, and you unlock him. Mil Máscaras, you do something to get him. I don't remember, but it's Mil Máscaras, WWE Hall of Famer right there, ladies and gentlemen. If you didn't know who Mil Máscaras was, he's in this game. So yeah, there's a lot of cool unlockables in this game, not just with costumes, but also with, you know, wrestlers and belts. I'll get to that in a bit. But let's talk about the MMA. So the MMA fighting style was really neat. Back in the day, I was a little bit aware of MMA. You know, I remember Ultimate Fighting when it was kind of like illegal and risque. Obviously, Ken Shamrock was probably like one of the more well-known American MMA fighters. We had, you know, Don Fry, who's in this game. He's a hidden character in this game. Dan Severn. You know, there's a few guys, but you know, people who really know a lot about MMA. You know, obviously they're gonna quote the Gracies and all these people. Rickson Gracie is in this game, as well as Royce Gracie. They're unlockables. Or maybe just one of them. No, I think they're both in this game. You know what? Let me look real quick. I think it might just be one of them. Hidden characters you have. All right. Well, you know what? I'll just tell you real quick. I'll just tell you who the hidden characters are. So let's go look at the... So, all right. So in this part, who we're missing? We're missing Jumbo Saruta. We got Mil Máscaras. We're missing Terry Funk and Dory Funk Jr. That's cool, right? We got Terry Gordy and Steve Williams, and you actually unlock those four, you unlock them as teams. When you do something, you unlock both of them at the same time, because they, you know, they were such popular tag teams over there. They were legends over there. All these guys are legends. This is why I put Legends 01, because in Japanese wrestling, they're legends over there. Just like how we would call like Ric Flair a legend over here, over there, you know, Terry Gordy and Steve Williams are legends. Bruiser Brody is in this game. Andre the Giant is in this game. Akira Mita, Alexander Carolin, Rickson Gracie, see, I was right. Mark Kerr, another, you know, Ultimate Fighting legend. Bass Rutten, another MMA legend. And then in the second branch, you have the Great Muda, you have Ultimo Dragon, Antonio Inoki. Okay, everyone knows Antonio Inoki. He was recently inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. You know, one of the top guys in New Japan Pro Wrestling. The original Tiger Mask, which is really cool. Naoya Ogawa, Ricky Chosu, Don Fry. I think I'm saying that right. I'm probably saying a lot of these names wrong, so excuse me if I am. Atsushi Onita and Yoshiaki Fujiwara. So a nice little mixture of legends, because not only do you have a lot of wrestling legends, you have a lot of MMA legends. MMA was a big deal in Japan. It still is, and a lot of its roots were in Japan. And a lot of the roots of, you know, MMA being a shoot or a work was in Japan. But basically, let's go to the moves. So if you go to the moves, right, their striking is all the same. Their striking is all the same. It's the grappling that's different. And I'll do a match. I'm going to do a regular match so you can just see the presentation of, like, doing a regular match. And then I'll do, like, an MMA match so you can see how the MMA system works. So you have a smaller set of grapples to choose. So obviously, if you're used to playing the wrestling games, you're like, okay, you have your weak A, your weak B, your strong A, your strong B, and then your special. Here, you only have your A and you have your B. And your B are striking moves. Now, you might remember, if you've played WCW NWO Revenge, some of the wrestlers, when you did a strong grapple, and you would hit the B button, they would go into this, like, combo system in a way. And if you pressed, you know, B, up B, down B, left B, right B, they would do these different strikes. If you've played as Goldberg in WCW NWO Revenge, then this rings a bell, because Goldberg had that system. Ultimo Dragon had that system. A few guys had that system. So when you play the MMA game, or MMA style, I should say, in this game, it works exactly like that. But you only have one grapple. You only have, like, an A grapple. And usually the MMA fighters, they'll have, like, takedown moves and stuff like that. So if you were wondering why a lot of these moves were in the game, in No Mercy, it's because this game had this tremendously complex MMA system. And then they all have a special, like a regular special, and you do that the same way. So it's really cool that they have that back grapple. They only have, like, the one grapple move. You know, you can't do anything else. And then you could steal a special. So their options were a little more limited in that sense. You can't throw MMA fighters. That's actually, like, a parameter you can set. When you go into parameters, you can set if they're gonna have an MMA fighting style, martial arts fighting style, or a wrestling fighting style. Now, the difference between, like, a regular martial arts fighting style and an MMA fighting style is the martial arts fighting style, you still have that combo system along with all the grapples. So basically, you can, like, recreate how, like, Goldberg was in this game, you know, if you want to keep him just like Revenge, because you can give him that martial arts fighting style in the game, and then he can do the combo system as well as the regular grapples. But he won't have the shoot grappling system like the MMA fighters. And if you look at the characters, see, like, how he has the red writing on the bottom right. He has the red writing, he has the yellow. So the red is the MMA, the yellow is the martial arts, and the, you know, regular white is the wrestling. That's how you know. So even if you, let's go back. So Baba has the martial arts, Misawa, Ogawa has the regular, Kakihara has the martial arts. So all the wrestlers have pretty much either regular wrestling style or a martial arts style to go along with it. It's not until you go with these, like, you know, off-brand MMA promotions. And I have to edit these. This is not really a promotion called Junks or Perfects. I think Perfects is supposed to be Pancrase. Or I think maybe Battle Arts is supposed to be I don't remember. One of them is supposed to be Pancrase. I'll do research. I'll probably do, like, a whole series of Let's Play videos focused on the MMA, because MMA is such a big deal now. I mean, you got the rise of ULC and Bellator is coming up now. I mean, you know, Brock Lesnar is a big crossover wrestling and UFC guy, but, you know, it's definitely different now than it was when Ken Shamrock came to the WWF. MMA is definitely more mainstream. A lot more people are into it. it's not as taboo as it once was. I mean, it's still a barbaric sport, don't get me wrong, but you know, people, it's more accepted now, I guess, because they realize they could just make so much money off of it. You know, I remember it was like sort of like borderline illegal, like even you know, it was very controversial. You could only have it like on pay-per-view, and only certain states allowed MMA matches, you know, UFC matches to occur. You know, that's why it was such a big deal in Japan, and that's why a lot of the advances in the world of MMA existed in other countries except for the US, because they weren't as, you know, I guess, hesitant to embrace the sport as they were over here. But nowadays, MMA is such a big deal. It, you know, now it's on basic television, right? I think I heard that, right? It's like on prime time. So yeah, so that's the roster. What else can I? Is that all I can talk about this roster? Let me see. I covered the MMA. I'm just gonna look at my notes real quick. Want to make sure I get a lot of the broad, general things about this game done in the introduction video, so that when I do the you know, when I do the regular Let's Plays, I don't have to spend too much time talking about, you know, all the different, you know, differences. I mean, I still talk about the differences between the games, but, you know, at least this is a great introduction for people who might not be more familiar. Yeah, I think I covered everything about the edit mode. You can, yeah, so let's jump right into a match. So let's do a regular match. All right, so this is, oh, well, before that, so this is single match, this is tag match, this is three-way, this is battle royal, so you can do, you know, four-person battle royal, they all come in preset or random, you can do up to 40, you know, just like the Royal Rumble, so if you're wondering if they kept that in the game, they did, but this is probably one of my favorite modes in the game. This is called elimination, and it's, you can choose the teams. You can choose, you know, how many people you want on your team, and the most you can choose is five. And basically, you can do this against the computer, you can do this against, you know, a friend. It basically, you just do the series of matches against each other. So, let's say my team, you know, I start off, I have The Rock on my team, and my friend, he has Stone Cold on his team. So, The Rock and Stone Cold fight. So, if I win, if The Rock wins, he moves on to face the second player on my friend's team, who happens to be Kane, okay? So he picks Kane as his second player, and you pick the characters before you start. And so The Rock is gonna fight Kane, but The Rock is gonna have all his damage carried over from the first match. And you basically, and they call it elimination, because you basically gotta eliminate everyone until you get to the end, until you eliminate the whole team. But the damage carries over. This is the most fun mode, in my opinion, when it comes to doing exhibition matches, because you could just jump right into the next match of the game. It puts you at a handicap, but at the same time, it makes it that more interesting to see who will come out on top, who will get the momentum going, who will win all five matches. If you can sweep your entire opponent, me and my friend used to play this game all the time, this game mode all the time, and there was occasions where we would go back and forth and it'll get down to the last guys. There was occasions where I would sweep him or he would sweep me, or, you know, one guy will get to the very end and he'll have his last character and then make a comeback and blow through the entire team. Some matches will go on for 10 minutes, some matches will go on for 1 minute. Love this mode. I just have to throw it out there. They never did this mode again, except they actually did do it in the first game. In WCW versus NWO World Tour, you had, you know, WCW versus NWO mode, which is basically you got to choose five WCW wrestlers and five NWO wrestlers and have this same exact elimination style mode where you went back and forth until there was one winner. I'm so depressed. I wasn't depressed, but I was a little sad that they took this feature out of No Mercy, because I felt like they could just kept it in. That would have been so cool, especially because you have all like the different, you know, franchises. You have like the Survivor Series. I mean, the whole Survivor Series is kind of like that. They don't stay in the ring. You know, it's just you do the single matches back and forth, and, you know, not all the wrestlers are in the ring at the same time, like a real Survivor Series, but it's kind of like that, the whole elimination style thing, just without the tagging. So yeah, I miss that mode a lot, and again, one of the other reasons why this game is probably my favorite, it just has a great balance and mix, you know, mix between all this. So you can choose your different settings, and they're based off of real Japanese location, the Kawasaki Stadium, the Aki Hall, which is the the Budokan Hall. No, this is the Budokan. This is the Budokan. This is the Tokyo Dome, and this is the Kakariku Hall. I'm forgetting what it was called. Hold on, let me look it up real quick, so I don't have to talk about it in another video. The Karakuen Hall. I can't even say it. Whatever. It's a famous hall in Japan. So we have the Tokyo Dome, and we're gonna do a regular singles match. And so let's do, so I can show you, let's pick someone familiar who people will probably be familiar with. Vader, who was one of the top guys at the time of this game's release. Let's have Vader, and he used to have great matches actually with Mitsuhiro Misawa and Kenta Kobashi. I'm gonna choose Misawa because Misawa is the kind of the top guy. So here you choose either wrestling or mixed martial arts. There's wrestling. Again, I've memorized these menus, so I kind of know, but you can kind of tell what this is. If you're familiar with all the games, this is like the count out. You'll get familiar with what's yes or no by the symbols. Obviously, that's all yes. This is all preset already. I am going to take off TKO. I don't know why TKO was on. Time limit 30. Time limit's actually really cool in this game because in Japan, in the Japanese wrestling, they'll call out like how long the matches are going. You know, the match is going for 5 minutes or the match is going for 10 minutes. And they do that in this game. And then you can always jump into the options and do the options real quick. So let's just go ahead and do a match. Vader against Misawa. And so here you can see the entrance. You just come in. And actually, I'm going to hold down one of the buttons. I'm going to hold down the left button for these guys so that you can see what I mean when you create your wrestler. You can come in and they say something. It's all going to be in Japanese now, but you can edit it in the option. You can edit each phrase what you want it to be. So when you're creating a wrestler and you want to give him something, like maybe let's say you're creating Goldberg, so you want to give him something to say, so you can put like who's next, you know, in the phrase, and he'll come out and say it. So that's pretty neat. You know, I think, you know, back in the day, I did one for Vader where I was like, it's time. It's Vader time. You know, cool stuff like that. So they come to the ring. And again, this is supposed to emulate the Japanese wrestling. So they're going to come to the ring and they're actually going to get their names announced. So here we go. Here's Vader talking on the mic. And he's doing this because I was holding the left C button. So he's saying something in Japanese. But this is really cool. I love this part. They introduce the wrestlers. So I'm just going to let this play so you can hear it. So that was really cool. You got to hear them, and you could kind of see, since this was the Japanese license, you could hear them say like Vader and Misawa. It's really cool. It's really unfortunate though, also at the same time, because when you create a wrestler, a fake wrestler, you have to kind of choose what they get announced as. So when you're creating wrestlers, you're just getting them like announced as like Vader or Misawa or stuff like that. So yeah, I'm gonna face Misawa. And this is like a live, this is happening live, ladies and gentlemen. I'm playing Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, my favorite wrestling game out of all of them. And another reason why this is my favorite wrestling game is because it's difficult. The difficulty is a lot higher, in my opinion, than No Mercy. I mean, I don't have any real facts to back this up. But considering I put thousands of hours into these games, even back then, I noticed that the computer was just a lot better in this game than No Mercy ended up being. Definitely harder in WrestleMania 2000. Probably as hard, not as hard as, I should say, as Revenge. Only because I felt like Revenge was a little broken in terms of how the computer countered you. I'm going to try to do this really quietly. Oh, I end up losing that one. I didn't want to make too much noise mashing on the buttons, but I guess my effort wasn't, you know, And a lot of the Japanese wrestlers like that, they have those counters where they'll just counter into a move. And because of the logic, they wrestle like how they would wrestle in real life. So you're gonna see Misawa go for his elbows a lot. You're gonna see him go for his spinning elbow, his roaring elbow, and when he goes for his finisher, he's gonna go for the Tiger Driver. Oh, you know what I forgot to mention? Oh, maybe I'll do it here. So they added something in this game where you can do like a second special, because so Japanese wrestling, it's kind of revolves around this whole strong style spirit, right? And think of like if every wrestler had like the ability to hulk up, right? That's kind of how it is in Japanese wrestling. Here they introduced the running grapple. Right there, Misawa did the running grapple. They didn't have that in WrestleMania 2000, which is kind of neat considering this game came out simultaneously, but there was no, or almost simultaneously, but there was no running grapple in WrestleMania 2000. But we would get the running grapple in No Mercy. So that was kind of a cool bonus when I remember I got this game, they actually added stuff to the grappling system that wasn't in WrestleMania 2000. So that was kind of cool. Felt like I was playing the future, you know what I mean? Not many people knew about it. Anyway, so like in Japan, you have kind of like the strong style spirit. And, it's basically like the toughness or, the perseverance of the wrestlers. See, this is why I chose Misawa, because now he's hitting me with a striking combination. And you can see, how the martial arts style works. Again, if you've played, Revenge, that looks very familiar. Okay, strong style spirit. Hopefully I won't get distracted again. It's the perseverance, the strength of the Japanese wrestler. Japanese wrestling is, it's the art of storytelling, really, like even to this day. But especially back then, it was all about telling these big dramatic stories in the ring between guys beating the crap out of each other for long periods of time and to seeing who will prevail. Very stiff in the ring with everyone working against each other. And the strong style spirit embodied that. In this game, they have, you can do two specials, okay? So when you do your first special, you taunt and your special meter goes up, just like, how it's always been done. But if you have a special, and not every wrestler has it, but if you have a special meter and your special's going, and if you taunt again, you'll get like your super special. Now the super special doesn't last as long, okay? It lasts like as a fraction of the time. But basically, the reason why that is because you can only get one opportunity to do it in the match. So like, let's say you do the super special, okay? And you pull it off. That's the only time you can pull it off. So if you're a wrestler, if the opponent you did it on kicks out of the move, then you can't do it again for the rest of the match. If you get another special in the match, you're only going to be able to do your regular special. If you taunt again a second time, it won't activate that second time. So it's really cool because, it really puts that dramatic flair. There's the announcer doing the 5-minute mark thing, like they do in the real, in real Japanese wrestling. I didn't do the running grab, the running suplex counter. I like doing that. So it adds like that dramatic flair that you see in, oh, Vader has the martial arts. I forgot about that. Okay, that's cool. I didn't even realize that he had that. I forgot all about that. I used to play as Vader a lot in this game. It's all coming back to me. A lot of counters, as you can see. It's already creating for an exciting match. I mean, if this was No Mercy, the match probably would have been over. But see, there's been a lot more counters and everything like that. A lot more exciting, which is why I'm excited to be doing this, these playthroughs with Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, because I feel like the matches are going to be a lot more exciting than my No Mercy Championship Run videos. I mean, those were good. Don't get me wrong. I don't want to, poo-poo on my own videos. But you know, just the fact that there's like so many counters and stuff like that. See, look, you didn't get this in No Mercy. You got this in Revenge, but you didn't really get it in No Mercy, where they're like just straight up countering you even when you have a special. But I'm still gonna give them the Vader Bomb. Let me see if I can do a taunt. Oh no, I couldn't get the taunt on off in time. Whatever, I'll go for the pin. That should be able to put Misawa away. Yeah. But see, now if he would have kicked out, we would have kept going. And then when I got my special, I probably would have done my super special to really put him away and really make a statement. You know, it took my super special to take down Misawa. Although I don't know if Vader has a super special. I don't remember. I know Misawa does, because Misawa does the Tiger Driver as his regular special. But then his super special is the Emerald Fusion or Emerald Erosion. I don't remember what he called it. It's been a while. I don't remember everything, guys, so forgive me. So there you go. There's the match. So now let's go to Aki Hall, and let's do a MMA match. So let's jump to I guess I'll play as Minoru Suzuki, and let's recreate. We're recreating Wrestle Kingdom 9 right now. So, all right, let me walk through this so that you can get an idea of how the MMA style works. So there I chose MMA. So now if you notice, let's go back. See, look, that's wrestling, right? You see how the setup is. Now we're at MMA. See, there's a little bit. There's one more option. So this is the rounds. So how many rounds you want to do? One round, two round, three round, blah, blah, blah. 15 rounds. You can do up to 15 rounds. They don't last that long. You can't really go 15 rounds in this game, honestly. Unless you're playing against someone who's also really good. But, you know, when it comes to submissions, after a while, you're going to make the guy tap out. So you can do rounds. So let's say, for the sake of argument's sake, 15 rounds, okay? So then, rope escape. So this is for the points. So if you're going to do a point system, right? So you get 2 points. For rope escape, or 1 point for rope escape. So I don't know. I guess points matter in MMA. Or you can put actually no rope escape. So this is free, and this is no rope escape. Okay, so that's kind of cool. So let's do rope escape, but it's free. Okay, then we have takedown. So again, you can get points, or you can just have it, you know, no points. Basically, you know, points is if you want to play the match to have a point system, or if you want to play the match to just until you make the other guy tap out or knock him out, okay? So then we have quick match, and we don't want a quick match. Now, if you remember quick match from, like, Revenge, basically quick match is, like, once you put the guy in the submission hold, they tap out. I guess that's to, like, make it more exciting if you're doing an MMA, because then, like, if you're not by rope break, they're gonna automatically tap out. But I don't know, quick match, it happens so fast, it's so easy to get the victory. But I guess that's what MMA is, right? You know, MMA matches don't last that long. I mean, Ronda Rousey, she just, you know, beat her opponent in what, like 14 seconds this past MMA fight. So I guess it makes sense if you want to really recreate that realistic MMA match type. What do we have? What's after that? After quick match, we have gong save. So if you want to do gong save for the round, so let's put gong save. Let's do yes. I put yes for the gong save. That's kind of cool. So second column. So time limit for each round. So let's put 3 minutes each round. So let's do that. And you can go many rounds. You can go hour for each round. You can go 60 minutes or no time limit. Which I believe is how some, you know, UFC fights way back in the beginning, some MMA fights were. They were like no time limit. It was basically until the other guy tapped out. And then lose when 3 points, 5 points, 10 points, or, you know, again, we keep it free. So basically we're going to do lose until pin, submit, or knock. Well, not pin, but submit or knockout. Knockdowns, again, these are the points, or you can do free for knockdowns, or you could do none, so I guess to cancel out TKOs, or What do we have? Give up, yes or no. You can actually put whether or not you want your character to submit or not. So that's kind of cool, because like if you want to do the whole point system, you can do it so that you're just getting points for, you know, takedowns and stuff, but you're not actually making the guy submit, because there's going to be rope break. So bloodshed, yes. Referee stops the fight or no. So let's just put yes. Not going to stop the fight because of blood. And then time decision, yes or no. So we're going to put no, because this is a, you know, basically this is a 3-minute, 15-round knockout / submission MMA fight. So this is going to be really cool. So you're going to see right off the bat, when you go for the grapple, it's gonna go for like it's kind of takedown grapple, you know, animation, which is really cool. And if you do a weak grapple, that's when you'll go into either doing your, you know, A grapple move, or your you know, B combo hitting move. And if you go for a strong grapple, that's when you do the takedown, and you go into a mount position, and from there you can just punch the guy, or you can make the guy submit. Again, I wasn't a big MMA fan, but it was really cool to see that in this game. It was so unique that they were able to pull off an MMA style fighting system in this game, and I think, you know, today it translates so well, because again of how big MMA is. So if you're an MMA fan, this is probably going to be a really cool treat, because just think about if they kept this system in No Mercy, you know what I mean, like how cool that would have been. Again, they probably just didn't keep it in No Mercy because at that time, you know, maybe the world wasn't ready. But imagine being able to have Ken Shamrock being the only MMA style fighter in No Mercy. That would have been pretty cool. So round one, here we go. You can't move him to the round. So now we got 3 minutes. So again, like the striking is the same. See, you strike like you move around like a regular wrestler. You can even run this and that. Now, see, when I go for the grab, you see how they make that different animation for the grab. So that's pretty cool. I'm already weak. Oh, come on, that was just a bam, got him. Okay, so I'm gonna show you real quick. You can't throw them. This is what happened when you try to throw, and you can put that in the parameters, because you know there's no whipping to the ropes in MMA. So here we go, sizing each other up. And you know, those strikes and everything that you might have seen in the game and thinking like, who does that? Well, the MMA fighters do that. If in No Mercy you were looking a lot of moves and like saying like, well, why is there a guy you can sweep a leg or something? It's because the MMA characters do. So that's pretty cool. Here we go. We're trying to just strike each other. Gave me a running shoulder block. So here, there we go. He goes for the mount. And did I not put rope break on? I thought I put rope break on. I guess I didn't put rope break on, so he's probably gonna make me tap out right now, because again, the submission skill and strength of these MMA characters are through the roof to fit the MMA style. But here I go, I'll give him a little rear naked choke of my own. It's actually how Minoru Suzuki won at Wrestle Kingdom 9. But so he went for the mount right there. So you can't pin. As an MMA fighter, you can't pin, but if you press the pin button, you'll go for the mount. And like right there, I went for the strong grapple takedown. Let me try to, boom, got him. So now see, when you do the strong grapple, you go into the thing, to the mount position, and you can beat him up, or you can do a submission. And I went for the submission there, and he countered it. So that's pretty cool, huh? So I think he's gonna automatically enter the ring. You can't leave the ring in an MMA fight, so that's really cool. But he's gonna taunt, really? You're gonna taunt at the ropes? Oh, and he blocked it. Oh, come on. Oh, and that's a knockout kick. That's a knockout kick. Come on, fight it. Oh, he's got the counter. Can I get up? I'm probably not gonna get up. Come on. Oh. Oh, I'm not too good in the MMA. See if I can recover. Oh, taking me down. This is not how Wrestle Kingdom 9 went down. but this is so cool. Like, this is so cool. Again, if you're an MMA fan, you can just do all these MMA style matches. A lot of MMA legends in this game. So mark out on all those MMA legends in this game. And I mean, you know, they got the UFC fighting game. you know, that EA makes and stuff like that. There I am mashing away the buttons. I'm trying not to mash too loud, but at the same time, I kind of don't want to lose. Got to try to kind of make a comeback. I think I'm going to get saved by the bell. Oh, my goodness. Ooh, saved by the bell. Now, your damage does take carry over. As you can see, I'm still holding my arm. And there he is just going to taunt. Let me see if I can make some sort of comeback. Play it safe. Don't want to, you know, just lose the match so quickly. Oh, that could have been a knockout right there. Just took that kick, you know. He's just kicking the crap out of me now. Oh, man. Oh, there I go for the sweep. And try to back him away. Now, the AI, you could kind of, like, make the AI do kind of some things, just like how in the other games. But still, as you can see here, the AI is a lot tougher in these games. He's gonna mount me. Oh no, he's gonna go for the armbar. Oh man, that could be it, because my arm was already, I was holding my arm. Oh, I am still in it. I'm still alive. But if he goes for another one, that's probably gonna be the end of me. Oh, spinning backhand. Let me try to get him with one of those. Oh, trying to get him with another one. Oh no, he's got me the takedown. Now, you block the punches with the R, and then, you know, for the grapple takedown, you can actually kind of grapple it counter with, like, you do a grapple counter for the submission, but there I go, I get tapped out. So I'm not as proficient in the MMA fighting style as, you know, the wrestling fighting style as I did with Vader. There I go, getting tapped out in my MMA re-debut in Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. I'm going to have to step up my game, though. I'm going to have to get better at the MMA because, you know, you do have to play as some of these guys in the Royal Rose Succession mode to, you know, unlock some characters. So, yeah, that's basically it. I mean, that's Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. A lot of cool features that aren't in the, you know, No Mercy game, that's not in WrestleMania 2000. My favorite wrestling game. I gave you a taste of all the wrestlers that are in it. Some you might recognize, some you might not. That is okay. I am going to make so many Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 videos. I am very excited. This channel has been kind of like a dream 15 years in the making. I talk about how if we had, you know, YouTube and Twitch and, you know, these capture devices and all this stuff that we have now, when I was younger, when I was a kid, when I would have had a well-developed channel around these games back then. I feel like over the years, time hasn't been so kind to these wrestling games because you know, I don't know. I don't know why. There hasn't been a lot of wrestling games in general made beyond, you know, WWF. Obviously, WCW folded. You know, you had an ECW game. You had a Ring of Honor game. I mean, not a Ring of Honor game. A TNA game. You had even a AAA game. But I feel like the quality just never really matched these, you know, AKI-developed wrestling games. And there's just something about the history of these games that just hasn't been cataloged. I mean, if you go on and you search, you know, Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 right now on YouTube, you won't find too much other videos, especially capturing directly from the cartridge. I mean, there's a few matches here and there. Like, you could see, like, a Jushin Thunder Liger match that someone recorded, but nothing really in-depth, nothing really talking about the history of the game, the historical context of the wrestlers in this game. I mean, I didn't even mention when I was going through the roster that 6 months later, Mitsuhiro Misawa and pretty much everyone else in the All Japan roster would walk. They would leave the company and form their own organization, Pro Wrestling Noah. You know, just stuff like that. You know, the fact that you can recreate all these classic wrestling matches with these legends like Terry Funk and Dory Funk Jr., guys who aren't in, like, these, you know, WWE games today. I think it's really cool how I go on YouTube and I look at a lot of the WWE wrestling games, like the new modern ones, and they try to recreate a lot of these Japanese wrestlers and even like the Japanese wrestlers of today. So you know, I want to put that out there. I want to put that out on YouTube. I want to show how great this game was, how great No Mercy was, Revenge was. There's not a whole lot of videos, you know, talking about the gameplay and the mechanics or the context of the games in terms of what was going on, you know, in wrestling at the time. If you've watched my No Mercy videos, you know, I talk a lot about the past, but I also sometimes talk about the present. You know, if I had all this equipment and all this time back in the day, I would all talk about, like, knee-deep what was going on at that moment and doing these videos. But, you know, the past is the past. The future, you know, the future is now for me, and this is a passion project. I'm so happy so many of you are excited about the videos I put out. A lot more videos to come. There's a lot of content to get through Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, and I'm gonna kind of handle it like I handled the No Mercy video series, where I go through the different championship modes. I'm gonna do the same thing with Virtual Pro Wrestling 2, kind of go through all the unlockables and do all that stuff, and maybe do you know specific focus episodes on other stuff. Maybe do episodes where I'll play it and talk about what's going on right now in the state of Japanese wrestling. Talk about the modern stars. Maybe even make some of the more modern stars now. Maybe make some MMA fighters. You know, I'm going to learn a lot about MMA by doing these videos, because I'm going to do a lot of research about these wrestlers, more so than I did back then. Because, you know, back then I just kind of ignored the MMA people. I didn't even think of it, you know, and then now that MMA is so big, you know, I kind of want to do research on that and learn the history of all that stuff. So I hope you guys learned something today. I hope you guys are excited about the possibilities coming up. This doesn't mean I'm going to stop doing No Mercy or Revenge videos. I got a lot of ideas for those videos coming up soon. I'm just going to alternate a bit. I think I might go week by week in terms of the videos I create. So you might see every week a new game. So you might see this week, you know, I'll just do a bunch of, you know, I'll record a bunch of Virtual Pro Wrestling 2 videos. And then next week, I'll do Revenge. And then maybe I'll get back to No Mercy the following week and rotate like that. I want to try to put out, you know, 3 or 4 videos a week. So let's see how it all, you know, boils down. You know, I always make these rules for myself and then end up breaking them or tweaking them. So let's just go with that for now. This week will all be Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. Next week we'll do some more Revenge, and then we'll go back to No Mercy. But hey, you know, I could always change my mind. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned a lot. I hope it gets you excited about Virtual Pro Wrestling 2. I mean, if you don't have an N64, if you don't have like $80 to spend on eBay getting a copy of this, you know, download the emulator. You know, whatever. It's a Japanese import game. It's not the easiest thing to get a hold of. But if you love the WrestleMania 2000 game, if you love Revenge, if you love No Mercy, and you've never played this game, go on GameFAQs. I'll put a link to all the guides I use for the translation. Download this game, or even buy this game if you have the means, and start playing this game right away. So what if it came 15 years ago? The engine never gets old. It's still fun today as it is back then, and it's never too late, as I'm, you know, proving right now with this YouTube channel. Hope you liked it. Leave a comment if you liked it. Go ahead and subscribe so you know when my next video comes out right away. And I will see you guys next time. Keep watching wrestling. Check out some Japanese stuff on YouTube. And I'll see you next time.